Welcome to the channel, and I have to say straight off the bat, when we speak about these things, I think it's very, very important that we are honest with ourselves and we are honest about our opinions. And for any football fan that put themselves in front of the camera and say something about what they think of, especially about what they think about their team, I think they have to be brutally honest and be ready to be crucified if they say something that is not right. And I have to say, I'm a Manchester United fan, and if I tell you that I'm happy with the season so far, I will be lying to you, because the same mistakes that I seen last season are the same goddamn mistakes that I see against Crystal Palace, that I see against Brighton, that I see against Spurs. And I mean, right off the top, like, the question I need to ask, like, I've been asking myself this question a lot during the game and after the game, is like, what position was Luke Shaw playing today? Because to me, it did not make any sense. He was playing more of a center back than it is of a left back. So I really trying to understand. It's like, was man marking Lamela the whole game? So for me, it's like, was that the strategy for the whole 90 minutes? I mean, like, from the first whistle, really, I mean, we did get the penalty. Yes, it was a penalty for Martial there. Bruno Fernandes, of course, scoring that. I think everybody was happy, saying, "Whoa, whoa, possibly 3 points." But for me, I was really watching the game, like, with an open mind, knowing what this team has produced so far this season. I really cannot be confident about this team going forward and maybe trying to get themselves 3 points, because I really did not see any goddamn 3 points anywhere in this game. I feel like we could have even lost this game, even playing with 10 men, if performances did not improve in any part of the game, really. So for this game, it was all Spurs, and I have to sit here and say, you know what, all the praise to Spurs. Congratulations to Mourinho. I think his team came out with only one goal in mind, and that one goal in mind for me is a winner's mentality, that you win every game by any means necessary. You go into any game with that mindset, like, you know what, we're gonna do everything in our power to win, even though they know, like, maybe they could have thought, you know what, maybe Manchester United is like a much better team than we do. They have players who are more capable than we are. But what we do have more than Manchester United is that we do have players with a lot of heart. We play with a lot of heart. Sometimes I feel like in football, you don't really need too much talent really to win any game. You just need a little bit more conviction. You need a little bit of confidence, and you need a little bit of heart as well, to make sure you really go into every game knowing, you know what, if we do what we came here to do with every strength that we have, we might get something out of the game regardless of who we play. I think that was the mentality in which Spurs came out of this game and tried to do. And boy, I have to say, they accomplished their goal to the T in this one. And I really hope that Manchester United players took some notes. For a player like Dombele for Spurs last season, I think everybody was saying, you know what, possibly this guy is going to be off. I don't think he's going to get along with Jose Mourinho as much as... like, I think everybody who was following the Premier League will say, you know what, wouldn't think Dombele will be at Spurs right about now. But he is the guy starting the big games now. What happened? I think the mentality changed. I think Jose Mourinho really had a good sit down with him and really had a real conversation. Like, what, you know what, Jose Mourinho probably broke it down to him. Like, you know what, this is what I expect from you. Like, I don't expect no less, no more. This is what I expect from you. Look at the goal that he scored to equalize. That's a goal of a player who's been told, you know what, All I want from you is absolutely nothing but your best. I don't expect nothing more, nothing less. I just want you to provide me with the best ability on the ball, on the team, with the team, in however way you can. Just provide me with your best and I'll be happy with that. I'll feel like that was the conversation which Jose Mourinho had with Dembele there. And look at what he's doing to Dembele. And that goal that he scored to equalize is not a player who's not happy with his team. It's not a, from a player who's not happy with his coach. I think he's very, very happy at Spurs at the moment with the conversation which he might have had with Jose Mourinho, and really breaking it down into pieces, into like, you know what, Jose told him, you know what, I need A, B, C from you. Can you give me that? And then he said, you know what, if you give me that, you and I will now have a problem. I think Dembele replied, you know what, I can give you A, B, C, D. And look at the performance that he was able to pull out in this game. And for me, I have to really, really sit here and say, you know what, well played by Spurs, by every single player for Spurs, even Lamela, for doing all he could to get Martial sent off. I think that's a winner's mentality. If anybody look at that strategy in that play in which Lamela just went on the floor just like that, as like, you know why, he's a weak player and stuff like that, I think you personally have a weak mentality, because you cannot win without a strategy. He came into this game with a strategy. He came into this game thinking, you know what, we need to try and rattle some feathers into this team and see how they can respond. And look at how Martial responded. Martial responded poorly, getting himself a red card, getting his team under pressure. I think from that point on, Manchester United were there for the taking, and boy, did Spurs do whatever they could to really put Manchester United to task. I think they did it very, very well indeed, and getting themselves 6 goals. Well-deserved 3 points to Spurs. I'm a Manchester United fan, and I'm going to hold my head on this one and say, you know what? We absolutely deserve the performance that we got and the result that we got against Spurs. We absolutely deserve it. The game against Crystal Palace on the opening day of the season, we did not deserve to win that game. We probably didn't even deserve to score that one goal that we when the game finished 3-1. We probably didn't deserve that either. And you can even argue with the game against Brighton going into that game. We really did not deserve to win that game, in my opinion. Look at how and the manner in which we managed to get ourselves 3 points in that game. That was very, very poor. To have to be decided by VAR to win a game against Brighton is pretty... If that alone really did not tell the whole story in which United are set to perform this season. And if this performance itself against Spurs does not really work up some of these players. I mean, the whole group. I mean, I cannot even pick on one player to say, you know what, this player did not play well today, because it was the whole team, from the goalkeeper to Martial at the very top. Everybody was very, very poor in this game. As for me, for Paul Pogba, we all sit here and say, you know what, Paul Pogba is the best. Paul Pogba hasn't shown his best at United. You can count with your fingers how many times Paul Pogba has come out and played to his best for Manchester United. You might argue, you know what, in the last 2-3 years or something like that, he really didn't have a support system like Bruno Fernandes. But now Bruno Fernandes is here. We don't expect too much from Paul Pogba anymore. So why not perform now? So what's the excuse now for Paul Pogba? Before, I can understand, you know what, we're expecting Pogba to get the ball from the back, get the ball from the midfield, create goals for Martial and whoever was at the front, like Lukaku and stuff. We're expecting Pogba to do all those things. Now he doesn't have to do all these things. Now all he needs to do is to win the ball from the back and just spray the ball around to open up spaces for to really open up teams and stuff like that. He's not even doing that. The only thing that we, the bare minimum that we actually expect from Paul Pogba now, now with that we do have Bruno Fernandes, who's available in front of him to really help him create more chances for the team. He's not even doing the basic that we should expect from Paul Pogba at this point in time. So my question will be, what's the excuse for Paul Pogba now? Because I've been watching a whole lot, reading a whole lot as well. I feel like Manchester United fans, most of them, they do have all these theories and all these excuses. Oh, it's like they're already written down just to make sure, like, everything, when every time things go wrong, we have something to say. We always have some type of rule book that we go to pick up an excuse and just throw it out there. Because right now, I don't find any excuse for players like Paul Pogba. I do not find any excuse for players like Rashford at this point in time. I do not find an excuse for players like Martial. Why are you not performing? Rashford hasn't been performing since, you could argue, after lockdown, really. He really has not performed to his best. So what's the problem there? Is he injured? Like, what is it? Because if he's not injured, so why is he on the team? This guy hasn't performed for a long time. And in this game as well, he started to really try to put passes together after 80 minutes. You're already six goals down after 80 minutes. What the hell are you trying to do at this, at that point? At that point, what the hell are you really trying to do? You couldn't do it in the opening 20 minutes. The opening 20 minutes should be a basic hard work for Manchester United to really try and push, put teams away in the first 20, 30 minutes. But it's not happening. Right now, beginning of the season, there is no game I can actually come here and say I went into this game confident that we're going to get ourselves 3 points. The game the game that really told me the whole story about this team right now was the game that was the opening game against Crystal Palace. After watching that game, I felt like, you know what, if things do not improve against Brighton, it's going to be a long season for Manchester United. And guess what happened? We did not turn up even playing against the team we should be brushing off, maybe scoring like 4 or 5 goals against. We could not turn up then. We were outplayed by Crystal Palace. We were outplayed by Brighton. And now we were outplayed by Spurs at home, to make matters even worse. At home, playing against Spurs, peppered 6-1. 6-1, and I cannot even go into how we conceded, especially the first 4 goals for Spurs. That second goal right there for Spurs, that's criminal, right? What type of defending, what type of training is going on in Manchester United? This is what I want to know. Like, that's one of the questions I've been asking myself after watching this game, because there was a lot of times in this game I wanted to really just, you know what, just turn the TV off, because it was just that bad. But the question I have is, like, what type of training is really going on there? What type of tactics are really going on at training to try and open up teams, or to even try and play well? The basic, just play well, keep the ball, make simple passes. This team cannot even do that. And how the hell do we expect to finish top 4? If I were to make my prediction right now, based on what I have seen in the opening 3 games of the season, for this Manchester United team, we'll be lucky to finish top 6. We'll be very, very lucky to finish top 6. We'll be very, very lucky to qualify to the round of 16 of the Champions League. We'll be very, very, very lucky if things continue in the same rhythm they are after these 3 games, or after these 4 games, because I think I've seen enough for me to tell me if things do not change after the international break, there's going to be a lot of hurting for Manchester United fans. There's going to be a lot of it's going to be a long, long season for Manchester United this time around, I think. So once again, I stand by it. You can clip this if you want to. Come to the end of the season, ask me again. Dilly, did you really think Manchester United can finish top four? Hell nah. This team is not finishing anywhere top four. The best this team can do is to really not try to embarrass themselves and finish in the top half of the table, I feel. With this performance that I see right now, I cannot put it past Manchester United finishing in the bottom half of the table. Maybe 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, right around there, fighting for relegation if this continues. I don't think we're going to get relegated. I don't think that's going to happen. But in terms of qualifying for European competitions for next season, it's going to take a lot to overcome the 6-1. It's going to take a lot to make this team come back into normality. It's going to take a lot to really change things around in this club. This club is rotten from top to bottom, bottom to top. This club really needs some real cleansing, if you ask me. Because it's not good enough. It's really not good enough. The players we expect to at least put in 70% effort, game in and game out, they just can't do it. It's like they just can't do it. I don't really think these players care enough for this team. There are some players you can look at, you know what, he's trying. At least he's trying. Bruno Fernandes, I can look at him and say, you know what, he's trying. Fred, I can look at him, you know what, he's trying. But the others, come on. Let's be real, come on. If you are a real Manchester United fan and you really care about the team and you really care about the players, like, come on. Let's not beat around the bush. This team is very, very poor to the core. Maybe it's just poorly coached. I do not know. But I would like to assume that these players are not coached properly. I think Ole Gunnar Solskjaer has shown us what he can and cannot do for Manchester United going forward. I don't think there's any excuses anymore for Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. I think he has done enough. For me, if I were a member of the board, I'll put him in as a director of football or something like that, but not as a coach. I don't think this guy is good enough for Manchester United, and I think there's a whole lot of players in this team that are just not good enough for this team. That's just not good enough to wear the badge. But let me know in the comment section down below if I'm overreacting, because it's really, really upsetting to see my team perform like this, to see my team go on like this. But yeah, let me know in the comment section down below how you guys feel. But I think the only positive I can take out of this game, out of today, is the fact that Liverpool managed to lose by 7-2 over Aston Villa. That's the only positive to my day today. If it wasn't for that, I'll be really, really down right now. I don't think I could even have the energy to make this video right here. So make sure you do comment down below. Make sure you do subscribe to the channel. I'm going to be doing a whole lot of this going forward, because I think we do need that little bit of criticism for our players. I've been watching a lot, and I think like some of these people, like, they just like to gas up players that are not good enough. They just like to gas up a team that's just not good enough. I think we need to be really, really honest of what we see and what we say. So yeah, hit me up. I think I'm gonna get a lot of banter in this for producing this video, but I can take it like a champ. So make sure you do subscribe to the channel. Comment down below. Let me know how you guys feel. I think this game was just another window into to see what type of team we have, and what type of mentality in the team that we have, and what type of coaching that we have, which if you really put it on a table, is pretty much nothing. We have nothing in this team to look forward to. And I think the only other positive is the fact that after this game, it is international break. Maybe we can cool off a little bit going forward. I would like to think that this team is going to come out firing against Newcastle, come back when they're coming back into the league competitions. They're going to come back firing against Chelsea. I'm pretty sure that's going to be a very, very difficult game as well. So if things do really, really do not turn around after this international break going into League Match Day 4, I think things are going to be very, very difficult for any Manchester United fan out there and for the players as well. I'm pretty sure it's hard for the players that really do care. But looking at it on TV, looking at it during the game, it's hard to argue that these players do care. It's really, really hard to argue that these players do care. I'm pretty sure they do. I'm not going to take that away from them. I don't know them personally. I don't speak to them. But looking at it, where it matters, when it matters, it seems like they just do not care. That's how I feel. That's my opinion. Let me know what your opinion is. And I'll catch you guys on the next video. I'm out.